Alright YouTube and Fallout community. So in this video we're going to talk about all the unique perks that are in Fallout 4. And if you've been around on my channel for a little while, I did a video like this for Fallout 3 of a couple months ago. And what I consider unique perks are the perks that are in-game that you get from not leveling up, just any other means outside of leveling up. And there's quite a few in this game because of the magazines and things like that and the companions. This was a really popular video on my channel, like for the one for Fallout 3. So I thought I'd just do one for Fallout 4. So let's get right into it. First up, we're going to the magazine perks. And the first perks are the Astoundingly Awesome perks, which come from the Astoundingly Awesome Tales magazines. There's 14 different ranks, or 14 different perks, and it varies to each magazine. So let's get right into it. The first one is regenerate 1 point of health per minute, do 5% damage with scoped weapons, take 50% less damage from robots, do 5% damage with the alien blaster, gain 5% poison resistance, do 5% damage against mire lurks, do 5% more damage at night, gain plus 5 action points, do 5% damage with the cryolator, gain plus 5 radiation resistance, Radaway heals plus 5% radiation damage, your canine companion permanently takes 10% less damage, do 5% damage against ghouls, and the last one is do 5% damage against supermutants. So that one's pretty crazy. There's a lot of those. Next up is Barbarian perk, and it comes from the Grognak magazines. There's 10 ranks to it, and you do plus 5% melee and unarmed critical damage. Next up is the Covert Operations perk, and it comes from the Covert Operations manual. There's 10 ranks to this as well. It makes you more difficult to detect while you're sneaking, so that's pretty cool. Next up is Guns and Bullets, which comes from the magazine called Guns and Bullets. And there's 10 ranks to this as well, and you do plus 5% ballistic critical damage. What that means is any weapons that use actual ammunition, like actual bullets. Next up is the Junktown Vendor perk, and it comes from the Tales of a Junktown Jerky Vendor. 8 ranks to this one, and you get better prices when buying from vendors. Next up is the Live and Love perk, and it comes from the Live and Love magazines. There's 9 ranks to this as well, and it also varies by every issue. And this one's pretty good for if you're really companion-based on your playthrough. First up is companions permanently gain plus 10 health. Companions permanently inflict plus 5% damage. Companions permanently gain plus 10 carry weight. Permanently gain plus 25% experience from persuading women. Permanently gain plus 1 luck from alcohol when traveling with a companion. Companions permanently gain plus 5 damage resistance and energy resistance. Permanently gain 25% experience from persuading men. Gain 5% experience while adventuring with a companion. And last up is robot companions permanently inflict 5% damage. So this one, since it's all companion based, probably pretty good with either any of the synth ones, because I'm pretty sure those would be considered robots, or of course Cosworth. Next up is the Massachusetts Surgery perk, and it comes from the Massachusetts Surgical Journal. There's 9 ranks to this, and what it does is it gives you 2% limb damage. Pretty simple. And there's 9 of it, so you get like a max at like 18% damage. Next is Tesla Science, which comes from the Tesla Science magazine. 9 ranks to this as well. It does plus 5% energy critical damage, so it's kind of the opposite of the Guns and Bullets one, except there's not as many ranks to it. Tumblers Today, and it comes from the Tumblers Today magazine. There's 5 ranks to this, and it widens the sweet spot when you're lockpicking, so it makes lockpicking a little bit easier. Next up is the Unstoppable perk, and comes from the Unstoppables magazine, and there's 5 ranks to this, and you get a plus 1 chance of avoiding all damage from an attack. So that one's pretty crazy, but in the end, it's only 5% chance of that happening, so it's kind of whatever. And then the very last magazine we got is the Wasteland Survival Guide, and there's 9 ranks to this. It comes from the Wasteland Survival Guide magazine, of course, and it varies by issue as well. First up is you heal 50% more from fruits and vegetables. You take 5% less damage from insects. You heal 50% more from irradiated packaged food and drink. You unlock new decoration items for your settlements. Diamond City is now marked on your map permanently, which is kind of a stupid one, I guess. I don't really understand that one. Gain 10% discount from food and drink vendors. Swim 25% faster. Take 5% less damage from melee attacks. And then the last one is collect more meat from animal kills. And then next up is the companion perks. And the first one is Trigger Rush you get from Kate. You gain your action points back 25% faster if your hit points are below 25% max. Next one is Robot Sympathy from Codsworth. You, You have plus 10 damage resistance against robot energy attacks. Combat melee from Curry, I don't know how to pronounce that, I haven't had this one yet. Can heal 100 HP if the current HP is below 10%. Know your enemy from Paladin Dance, 20% more damage against synths, ghouls, and supermans. Cloak and Dagger from Deacon, 20% sneak damage, and your stealth ward durations are 40% more. Isodope from Hancock, critical increase, your criticals recharge 20% faster, or 20% more if your rads are at least 250. Close to Metal from Valentine, one additional guess when hacking, and there's 50% faster cooldown at terminals, which I don't exactly know what that means. Gift of Gab from Piper, gain double experience when persuading and discovering new locations. United We Stand from Preston Garvey, 20% more damage resistance and damage when outnumbered in a fight. Berserk from Strong, 20% more melee damage if your HP is below 25%. Shield Harmonics from X688, 20% energy resistance if hit by energy weapon. And then lastly, of course, is Killshot from McCready. If you watch my channel, you know what this is. 20% more accuracy for headshots and VATs, but of course we know that is beyond bugged. And then next up we got the temporary perks, which is only three of these. Well Rested is 10% more experience for 12 hours when you sleep. Lover's Embrace is 15% more experience for 12 hours when you sleep in a bed with a romantic companion. And then this one's pretty interesting and kind of weird. Quiet Reflection plus 5% experience for 8 hours. And you get this for sitting in the pew at the All-Face Chapel in Diamond City. I thought that was kind of interesting. I didn't even know that thing was a thing. I don't know if any of those can stack at all. Like if you can sleep in a bed and then sit in the pew and then like maybe you get like a shit ton of experience. And then the last unique perk in the game, and it's like a secret or hidden perk. And there's only one of these that we know of so far, and it's a console command perk, and it's called Less Stagger. And you drastically reduce all melee stagger effects. So that's kind of, I don't know, that's kind of interesting that there's like a console command perk. But yeah, that's it for the unique perks that we know of so far in Fallout 4. There may be more discovered at a later time. I mean, the game is only like, you know, not even a month old yet. And there's also future DLC, which could introduce more perks, more companions, which would have perks with them as well. But that's it for the video, guys. Social networks are always below. Later.